Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. So in this video, we will see how to use this op-amp as a summing amplifier and using this op-amp configuration, how we can add the different input voltages. So now in the earlier video of inverting and the non-inverting op-amp configuration, we have applied the single input either to the non-inverting or the inverting op-amp terminals. Now in this video, we will apply the multiple inputs either to the inverting or the non-inverting op-amp terminal, and we will see how this configuration can be used as a summing amplifier. So first we will see the inverting summing amplifier, and in this configuration we will apply the multiple inputs to the inverting input terminal, and we will find the expression of the output voltage in terms of the different input voltages. So as you can see here, we have applied the input voltages V1, V2 and V3 to this inverting terminal via resistor R1, R2 and R3. And here let us assume that current I1, I2 and I3 are flowing through this resistor R1, R2 and R3. And let us say the current IF is flowing through this resistor RF. And here we are assuming the op-amp as an ideal op-amp. So no current is going inside this op-amp. And let us consider this node as a node X. Now in the earlier video of inverting op-amp configuration, we have seen the concept of virtual ground. And in that concept, we had seen that whenever we are applying the negative feedback to any op-amp, then there is a virtual short exists between the inverting and the non-inverting terminals. So if one terminal is at ground potential, then another terminal will also be at a ground potential, or we can say that it will act as a virtual ground. So this node will have a zero potential. So now let's apply a KCL at this node X. So applying KCL, we can write I1 plus I2 plus I3 that is equal to this current IF. Now as this terminal is at ground potential, so the current I1 will be equal to V1 minus 0 divided by R1. Likewise, this current I2 will be equal to V2 minus 0 divided by R2. And likewise, current I3 will be equal to V3 minus 0 divided by R3. Now this current IF will be equal to 0 minus Vout divided by this feedback resistor RF. That is 0 minus Vout divided by this feedback resistor RF. So if we simplify this expression, then we can write it as a V1 divided by R1 plus V2 divided by R2 plus V3 divided by R3 that is equal to minus Vout divided by RF. And if we further simplify it, then we can write it as a Vout that is equal to minus RF divided by R1 times V1 plus RF divided by R2 times V2 plus RF divided by R3 times V3. Now we know that if we apply the single input to this non-inverting op-amp configuration, then the output voltage Vout can be given as minus RF divided by R1 times input voltage. Now here, instead of single input voltage, we have applied the multiple input voltages. So the output voltage will be equal to the algebraic sum of the individual responses. So this is the expression of the output voltage in case of the inverting summing amplifier. Now in this inverting summing amplifier configuration, let us assume that the value of R1, R2 and R3 is same. So in that case, the output voltage Vout will be equal to minus RF divided by R times V1 plus V2 plus V3. So now here, if value of RF is equal to R, then in that case, our output voltage Vout will be equal to minus V1 plus V2 plus V3. So in this way, we can use this op-amp as an adder, and we can add the multiple input voltages. So now suppose in this configuration, if R1, R2 and R3 are different, then in that case, the ratio of this feedback resistor over these resistors R1, R2 and R3 will also be different. So in that case, along with the addition, we can also perform the scaling operation. So in that case, our output voltage Vout will be equal to minus A times V1 plus B times V2 plus C times V3, where A, B and C represents the ratio of this RF divided by R1, RF divided by R2 and RF divided by R3. So along with the addition, we can also perform the scaling operation. So along with this scaling and the addition operation, we can also perform the averaging operation using this configuration. So now let us see how we can perform the averaging of the different input voltages using this configuration. So let us once again assume that the R1, R2 and R3 are having a same value. And let us say the ratio of this RF divided by R is equal to 1 divided by N, where N represents the number of input voltages that is being applied to this inverting terminal. So in that case, our output voltage Vout will be equal to minus RF divided by R times V1 plus V2 plus V3. And if we put the value of this RF by R as 1 over N, that is equal to 1 over 3 in this case, then our output voltage will be equal to minus V1 plus V2 plus V3 divided by 3. So in this way, our output voltage will be the average of the three different input voltages. So we can also perform the averaging operation using this configuration. So now let us see some more applications in which this inverting summing amplifier can be used. So as I already told you, this summing amplifier can be used for the operation of addition, averaging as well as the scaling. Apart from that, it can also be used to provide the DC offset to the input signals. So suppose if your input voltages are AC signals, or let us say it is coming from some sensor, and if you want to apply some DC offset, then using this configuration we can also apply some DC offset to the incoming signals. Likewise, this inverting summing amplifier can also be used for the digital to analog conversion. And apart from that, it can also be used for the mixing the different audio signals. So these are the different applications in which this summing amplifier can be used. Now theoretically, we can add the n number of input voltages to this op-amp configuration, but practically if you see, the number of input voltage depends upon the power dissipation as well as the total current that can be supplied by the op-amp. Because here if you see, the total current IF is the summation of the individual currents I1, I2, I3 up to IN. So this value should not exceed the maximum value that is supported by the op-amp. Now one more interesting fact about this inverting op-amp configuration is that all the individual voltage sources are isolated with respect to each other, and that is because of the concept of virtual ground. Because if you consider the individual voltage sources at a time, then at that time the remaining voltage sources will act as a short circuit. So if we consider this voltage source V1 that is acting alone, then at that time this voltage source V2 and V3 will be act as a short circuit, or we can say that they are at a ground potential. Now because of the virtual ground, this node is also at a ground potential. So we can say that effectively this R2 and R3 do not exist in the circuit. So the effective impedance that is seen by this voltage source V1 is the series resistance R1 of that particular voltage source. So we can say that there is a no interference between the different voltage sources, and that is the biggest advantage of this inverting summing amplifier. Now the output of this inverting summing amplifier is the negative voltage, but suppose if we want the positive voltage, then what we can do, we can connect one more inverting op-amp which is having a unity gain. So as you can see here, suppose if we connect one more inverting op-amp which is having a unity gain at this point, then the output voltage will be positive. So by using one more inverting op-amp, we can get the positive output voltage. So this is all about the inverting summing amplifier. Now let us see what happens when we apply the multiple input voltages at the non-inverting input terminal. So now in this non-inverting summing amplifier, we have applied the two input voltages at this non-inverting end, and we will find the output voltage in terms of the input voltages V1 and V2. Now we know that in case of this non-inverting configuration, the output voltage is equal to 1 plus RF divided by RA times the voltage at this node. Let us say that is equal to V plus. So as we have applied the multiple input at this end, so first of all we need to find this voltage V plus, and we can do so by applying the principle of superposition. So what we will do, we will consider the one voltage source at a time, and we will find the voltage at this node, and later on we will combine the individual responses to get the final response. So first of all, Let us assume that this voltage source V1 is acting alone and we have removed this voltage source V2. That means V2 is equal to 0. So for that case, let us say the voltage at this point is equal to V1 plus. So V1 plus will be equal to R2 divided by R1 plus R2 times this voltage V1. Likewise, when we consider this voltage source V2 is acting alone and V1 is equal to 0, in that case, the voltage at this point is, let's say, V2 plus. So V2 plus will be equal to R1 divided by R1 plus R2 times this voltage V2. So in this way, when this voltage source V1 and V2 are acting alone, then in that case, the V1 plus will be equal to this value and V2 plus will be equal to this value. So the overall voltage V plus will be equal to the summation of individual voltages, that is V1 plus plus V2 plus, that is equal to R2 divided by R1 plus R2 times V1 plus R1 divided by R1 plus R2 times V2. So this will be the voltage at this end because of this voltage V1 and V2. Now we know that the output voltage is equal to 1 plus RF divided by RA times the voltage at this end, that is equal to V plus. So our final output voltage will be equal to 1 plus RF divided by RA times this R2 divided by R1 plus R2 times V1 plus R1 divided by R1 plus R2 times V2. So this will be the final voltage that we get at the output of this non-inverting summing amplifier. So now let us simplify this equation a bit and let us assume that this R1 is equal to R2 is equal to R. So when R1 is equal to R2 is equal to R, then in that case, the output voltage Vout will be equal to 1 plus RF divided by RA times V1 plus V2 divided by 2. Now if we consider RF is equal to RA, then in that case, the output voltage Vout will be equal to V1 plus V2. That is the addition of the voltage V1 and V2. So in this way, using this non-inverting summing amplifier also, we can perform the addition. Now let us take the case when we have a 3 different input voltages that is connected to this non-inverting terminal. So as you can see here, we have a 3 different input voltages V1, V2 and V3, which are connected to this non-inverting terminal via resistor R1, R2 and R3. So here also we will consider the one voltage source at a time and we will find the voltage at this non-inverting terminal. And later on we will add the individual responses to get the voltage at this non-inverting terminal. So first of all, let us assume that this voltage source V1 is acting alone and V2 and V3 is equal to 0. So in that case, the circuit will look like this. So the voltage at this point, let us say, is equal to V1 plus. So V1 plus will be equal to R2 parallel R3 divided by R1 plus R2 parallel R3 times this voltage V1. So this is the voltage that you get at this point when this voltage source V1 is acting alone. Likewise, we can have a voltage V2 plus that is equal to R1 parallel R3 divided by this R2 plus R1 parallel R3 times this voltage V2. This is the expression when the voltage source V2 is acting alone. Likewise, we can have a V3 plus that is equal to R2 parallel R1 divided by R3 plus R2 parallel R1 times this voltage V3. So the total voltage that appears at this point will be the summation of these individual voltages. So as you can see here in this non-inverting configuration, as the number of input voltages are increasing, the complexity is also increasing. And to here reduce the complexity, let us assume that R1, R2 and R3 are equal. So when all the three values are same, then the value of V1 plus will be equal to V1 divided by 3. Likewise, the value of V2 plus will be equal to V2 divided by 3. And likewise, V3 plus will be equal to V3 divided by 3. So in short, when R1, R2 and R3 are equal, in that case, the V plus will be equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3 divided by 3, and the output voltage V out will be equal to 1 plus RF divided by RA times this V plus, or we can say that 1 plus RF divided by RA times this V1 plus V2 plus V3 divided by 3. So now suppose if the value of 1 plus RF divided by RA, that is equal to 3, in that case the V out will be equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3. So as you can see here, in this configuration, as the number of input voltage increases, the complexity is also increasing, and here the individual input voltage that appear at this point is not only depend upon the value of this V1 and R1, but it also depends upon the different series resistors of the individual voltage sources. Like here in this case, it also depends upon the value of this R2 and R3. So in this configuration, we can say that the individual voltage sources are not isolated with respect to each other, and they have their own influence on the input voltage that appears at this non-inverting terminal. So that is the reason in most of the practical applications, this inverting summing amplifier is more preferred over this non-inverting summing amplifier. So that is all about the inverting and the non-inverting summing amplifiers. So I hope in this video you understood about this inverting and the non-inverting summing amplifiers. If you have any question or suggestion, do let me know in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more such videos.